This illustration describes about the situation of a bullet hitting a ball. Here we are given that a bullet of mass m moving at a speed v hits a ball of mass capital M capital S, and a small part of ball of mass m1 breaks from the ball and sticks to the bullet. It is saying the remaining ball is found to move at a speed v1 in the direction of bullet. So now we are required to find the velocity of bullet after the collision. Here, to understand the situation better, let's draw a figure where we are given that there is a ball of mass capital M which is at rest, on which a bullet which is of mass small m is approaching at a speed v. When the collision takes place, after collision, this is the situation we can write before collision. And here we draw the situation after collision, where the ball will be having a mass m minus m1, and it is given that it is found to move at a velocity v1, and when the bullet comes out from the ball, this mass m1 which breaks from the ball sticks onto the bullet, so its mass is m plus m1, and say it is moving with the velocity v2, so we are required to find this velocity. Here we can directly write, as no external force is present on system, here we use conservation of momentum, as here we can use initially before collision the bullet is having a momentum mv and there is no momentum in ball, but after collision if we talk about the momentum in ball, the momentum is m minus m1 multiplied by v1 plus in bullet it is m plus m1 multiplied by v2, where we are required to find the value of v2. So directly from this equation we can get the value of v2, which is mv minus m minus mv1 divided by m plus m1. So this is the result of the problem. Directly by using conservation of momentum we can find out the velocity of bullet after collision.